I am Susan Taylor with Scripps Health in San Diego, California. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, some 40 million adults in the U.S. have some type of hearing loss. Joining us is Dr. Thomas Alexander. He's a neurotologist and ear surgeon with the Scripps Clinic Medical Group in La Jolla, California. Doctor, thanks so much for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
So what causes hearing loss?
So there are several different things that can cause hearing loss. So here's a model of the ear to try to explain that. So sound has to get through your ear canal and then go deeper into the eardrum, and the eardrum has to vibrate, and then the attached hearing bones have to move and vibrate, and then that causes movement inside the hearing organ called the cochlea, and there are little cells that detect that and trigger a nerve impulse to the brain. So the most common type of hearing loss is where the cochlea that is taking the mechanical sound energy and turning it into a nerve impulse has stopped working. And that's what most people who have hearing loss have. That's the one that's caused by noise exposure throughout life. A less common cause is conductive hearing loss, where something is just physically blocking sound transmission from outside the head to inside the head. And that's one that usually we can repair by surgery or medicines. And then you can have a mixed hearing loss where it's a combination of both of those two types. And then the least common is where there's a problem with the nerve only or with the brain itself, where the speech is not getting encoded properly or the brain can't interpret speech. And that would be called an auditory spectrum disorder, but those are extremely rare.
So what about the loud bass sounds from everyday activities, such as, let's say you work at a construction site, or what about leaf blowers or going to a concert, for example, or a loud sporting event? Can that give you hearing loss?
Really, any loud sound can cause hearing loss. And it's a combination of how loud the sound is and how long you're exposed to it. And so you gave the example of a leaf blower. A leaf blower is about 85 decibels, which is a measurement of loudness. And you might be able to be exposed to that for 2 hours before you have damage, but a jackhammer might be more like 120 decibels, and that can potentially cause instantaneous damage to your ears.
And then what about the use of headphones or earbuds? Because people are using these all the time, right? As they're listening to music or streaming video on their laptops or on their cell phones.
Yeah, so it's important to try to keep it at a reasonable volume. And if you have it even at a moderate volume, if you're listening to it all day long, that can conceivably cause damage.
Now, almost one in four adults ages 20 to 69 who reported really good to excellent hearing already have some type of hearing loss. How is that possible?
So all of us are slowly losing high frequency hearing throughout life from noise damage. It turns out that our ears are so sensitive and so delicate that our daily lives are too loud for them. And so the longer we live, the more noise we're exposed to, the more high frequency hearing loss occurs. And so even young people can start to notice that.
And hearing loss increases with age.
Yes. So one in five adults age 20 to 29 will have a significant hearing loss. One in four from age 50 to 59. And then by the time you get to age 80, it's 9 out of 10.
And who is more at risk, men or women?
Generally, men are more at risk.
And how can you detect that you're starting to have problems hearing?
What most people notice first is they hear fine if they're in a quiet environment or one-on-one, but if there's any background noise, they have a harder time understanding what people are saying and have to start asking people to repeat themselves. And the reason for that is we all are slowly losing our high frequency hearing throughout life because of noise damage. And it's the high frequency sounds that are most important for the brain to filter out background noise for us. The brain actively suppresses surrounding sound to allow us to understand speech that's coming from in front of us, and we start to lose that ability first.
And then if left untreated, hearing loss can have some unsettling social side effects. What are they?
Yeah, definitely significant hearing loss can lead to social isolation, that can lead to depression, and there has been an association discovered with significant hearing loss and the risk of progressing to dementia.
So if you have hearing loss, how can you make sure that it doesn't get worse, and how can you correct it?
So one of the ways to try to keep it from getting worse is to be sure to protect yourself from loud noise exposure. To get a handle on it, the first thing to do is to get a hearing test with an audiologist so they can figure out exactly what type of hearing loss it is, and exactly how severe it is. And then for most people, it'll turn out to be a sensorineural hearing loss. And the treatment option to start with is typically hearing aids.
And do you have a hearing aid there that you can show us?
So here's an example of a hearing aid. It's got a small piece that goes over the ear with the battery and the processor. And then it's got a little tube that goes down into the ear canal where the speaker is.
And that's how it works. So it's putting a speaker actually in the ear so that you can hear better.
Yes.
And what about the cochlear implant? What is that and how does it work?
So a cochlear implant is a device that can restore hearing for someone whose hearing loss is so severe that they can no longer get sufficient benefit from hearing aids. It's a surgically implanted device that can provide sound by electrically stimulating the hearing nerve. And so it can take someone who's functionally deaf and allow them to understand speech again.
Wow, that's
interesting. So here is an example of the implant part. So this is the part that would go inside of the patient. And it's got a tiny little coiled electrode that gets fed into the hearing organ, the cochlea, and then it can activate the hearing nerve. And then on the outside, the patient wears something that looks kind of like a hearing aid. So it's got the microphone and the computer and the batteries, and then it's got a magnet that lines it up with the part that's on the inside. And that looks something like this. So here's a cochlear implant on the ear, and then the magnet that connects to the part on the inside.
And so when you implant that device, how extensive is that surgery? Is that something that you go in and out of the hospital the same morning or a doctor's office? Or
it's an outpatient surgery done in an operating room. The patient would be asleep with a general anesthetic. It takes about an hour and a half or so to put the device in, and then they would wake up and go home the same day. And then they'd wait about a month for things to heal up, and then they'd have the device turned on and start learning to hear with it.
So how do you prevent hearing loss? Obviously avoiding really noisy places and you know, putting in earplugs. What else can you do to help prevent that hearing loss?
Yeah, so really earplugs are the main thing. It's possible that noise canceling headphones might be helpful. So it's really just a matter of trying to limit the volume of noise you're exposed to and especially avoiding long durations of loud volume.
Well, let's say somebody loves to go to concerts. You know, what would you do in that case?
Yeah, definitely wear earplugs. And you know, what earplug is right depends a little bit on exactly how loud it is, but for most concerts, the foam insert earplugs that you can get at any drugstore work well. You can have what are called musician's earplugs made, which are created in a way to try to maintain the fidelity of the frequencies of music, but reduce it to a level that's not damaging to your ear.
So how loud should you be playing the TV or the earbuds for your cell phone or your laptop?
Yeah, it's hard to give a definite number for that because everybody's TV and earbuds are going to put out a different amount of volume, but it should definitely just be at a comfortable level. You know, normal conversation is about 60 decibels of sound. A lawnmower is about 85 decibels of sound. In between that, at 70 decibels, we know that sound at or above 70 decibels for extended periods of time can cause damage to the ears.
Any final thoughts, doctor?
Yeah, I would just want people to know that if they notice that they're having increasing difficulty understanding speech, that would be a good time to come in and get a hearing test to find out exactly what's going on with their ears.
And what would that hearing test include?
So that would involve measuring the quietest sound that can be heard at every different frequency. It'll involve a test that'll figure out whether a hearing loss is sensorineural or conductive, like we talked about earlier. And then they'll test the movement of the eardrum and the pressure behind the eardrum to try to figure out exactly what might be causing the hearing loss.
Doctor, thanks so much for taking the time to be with us. We really appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
If you want more information on hearing loss, just click on the link or go to scripps.org/videos. Want more critical information about your health? Please subscribe to our Scripps Health YouTube channel and follow us on social media at Scripps Health. At Scripps, we're here for good. I'm Susan Taylor. Thanks for joining us.